Hi guys, welcome, welcome. So, I'm just doing some tech packing for a new collection, and I thought, why not just like show you the process as I do it? Why not bring you along? So, if you want to do some tech packing with me, if you want to see some of my sample development on the go, literally here, just sat at my desk, my laptop, just tech packing along, doing some CAD illustrations as well. I can show you all about that. And so if this is anything that is interesting to you, just stick along and let's do it. Let's do some tech packing. All right. So I'm pretty much just here talking to myself right now. But I'll just begin. Let's go. Let's get into it. Cool. Just thought I'd get the intro out of the way. Lovely. So, what is Tech Pack, first of all? I'm here talking about I'm tech packing, come and join me. But if you don't know what a tech pack is, it's probably best I explain. And, you know, I'm going to flick over to my screen so you can have a nice view of what I'm doing. But, right. So when you're developing a range, when you're developing even one garment, to be able to communicate what garment you are trying to develop, its measurements, its size, its fabric, its makeup, all of those kinds of things are put together in various amounts of detail, and that the collection of all of that information is what we call a tech pack in the buying and merchandising world, in the design world, in any, you know, retail development process. We call that a tech pack. So I'll just try and flick over to something here. Let's try and get you over to my screen. Okay. I've got a lot of screens going, so this is going to be a bit of a process. Okay. So what I've got here is kind of an example of a tech pack. Right, let me just try and get it a bit bigger for you. And I'll take myself off. How do we do that? Okay, I just need to know if that is actually on the screen. Nice. this is an example of a tech pack, and it's a very simplified version. So what I have here is the first garment that I am developing. I'm quite a few processes, like steps ahead, and you know, I can go back and explain all of this, but just as a view, what I'm trying to achieve is this and some detailing in terms of literally all the measurement points here to be able to get us a finished sample. This is what we send over to the factory, and they will use this to actually sew up a garment for us. I have a few more examples. Let's see what I can get. Right. It's gonna take me a minute to get into the flow of what I'm doing, because I've actually never done this before in terms of a live streaming while working. This is very interesting, but it's not bad. It's actually more helpful for my uploads. I've been gone for ages, and it's because of stuff like this. Like, I don't have the time to work and then do an upload or do a recording of a how-to. This is just everything in one, so I am very happy. Just bear with me. It may be a bit of a slower process to watch, but oh, bless me. Lovely. Great. So I'm just gonna take it all the way back, guys. So I am developing a new range. It's going to be called Dress for Success, and it's business attire. It is essentially feminine business attire. And so, as you can see here, I've honed in on the blazers in particular. I thought I'd start with, you know, sketching up some nice blazers, just getting the shape of it, the feel of it, and deciding what I actually want to go in and make, like, sample. So the design process is a very lengthy process of experimenting, and this is, I just thought I'd share with you my experimenting process. I'll try and zoom in a bit. Right, here we go. Let's get into it. I will do some detailed videos on literally how I CADded all of this up. For anyone who doesn't know, CADding is computer aided design. It's used in a lot of industries, not just fashion design. You know, anything that's produced, anything that makes a product would use computer aided design. Cars get CADded, architects do CAD. So yeah, just as an idea, these have literally been sketched up. I'll like ungroup just so you can have a bit more of a view of like literally. Right, this was my first initial shape that I did ages ago. This is from my first range that has been documented. I did this quite a while ago and did a whole shoot on that had this in it. So for Dress for Success, I knew I wanted to do blazers, and so I started with this shape because it's, you know, it's like a starting point. You're starting from somewhere that you've already been. And from that blazer shape, I just decided to move along and see what else I could do, but make it a bit more businessy. So here we've got something where I've done like a bit of a cutout, and it's like I added a pinstripe on it to make it look a bit smarter, something you could wear to work. You'd put over a shirt, you would not wear the cutout on your, like, just revealing your midriff. Just FYI, just as a disclaimer. But yeah, there's something fun but still a bit businessy just going on there. So yeah, there's also some like added swatches up here to really see like what else this could be done in. So yeah, I'm just taking you through all of the CADs that I've done, all of the designs that I've kind of flirted with for this range, because I want to bring you in from the beginning of the process. I think it would be fun to document how all of this comes together, So another one is this, which is, initially I had sketched this out. These are all actual sketches that I've scanned in. So I sketched this on paper and then just scanned it into Illustrator and then done like some neater CADs. And drawn them up here because these CADs are what the factory, the manufacturers require before they do any sampling. It's difficult for them to manufacture something off of a hand-drawn sketch, so you make it as clear as possible for them, and you just have it neater in your head, even just for yourself, to know really what it is you're trying to make. And then again, I've got some swatches collected here that I was kind of flirting with. Had another pinstripe there, and then some, lighter ivories and like a nice green. I don't know, I was just thinking of what that could be in. These are really out there. Definitely not businessy, but I was looking at, the whole blazers set. I had this picture of like Molly May and like a really interesting, I don't know if you could see this, but it's like different fabric on each side. So yeah, I was flirting around with that. These CADs were, yeah, again, very out there. This went crazy. But yeah, that's the design process. You really experiment, you're experimenting, and it takes nothing from you to experiment with it on Illustrator. That's the very handy thing with illustrating, because you're not wasting any sampling. You're not like, it's just you're playing with the idea. So I'll show you where this shape came from. I'll have to scroll further down. There is a blazer set that I did a while ago, which was this, and it was literally just your normal men's blazer. Actually, it was a men's jacket, men's suit jacket that I cut up and kind of added some studs on and like shifted the right side of the paneling and kind of made it this whole new thing. And so put a belt around it. I'll zoom in on this. Hopefully you can see that a bit better. Yeah, and I did that live on a kind of fashion week event for, our community. And so that was just something that I thought I could sketch up and run with. So when I did CAD that up, like this is one example of that CAD, I decided to now play around with different fabrics of this, So that's another part of designing. Sometimes the design isn't like, it can go backwards. It can be like it started off in the physical rather than sketching it first and then making it. Here, I actually made it and then sketched it. So it's just all, there's all kinds of things that happen in the designing process, which I've just tried to like collate here for a bit of a view for you. And also to show that designing is just playing, it's experimenting, and that's what was happening here. So I'll take you back up to that section just so we can go in a bit of order. Yeah, so when I now knew that shape existed, I CADded it and I played around with more fabric. I found these fabric swatches up here found these fabric swatches from, I am subscribed to various manufacturers, various suppliers of fabric, trims, garments, all kinds of things. And I browse them regularly just to see what the latest, you know, fabrics are, what's the most overly bought fabric, or what's the most overly bought trend that retailers are buying into. So then that's a picture of knowing what's going to make some good sales. So I'm not saying these are, because this is very old work from a good 6 to 12 months out, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, I just put that all down here just to see how it would look. And I didn't like how this looked. It was crazy. I would not make any of these, I do not think. So yeah, but it was good to put down, and it's good to have. And also the fun thing with these things is you actually never know when something's gonna like come back around and be trendy, or, you know, so I always keep my work. I'm definitely not gonna like let that just go to waste. I'll take you round to some more. Right. This is something that I sketched as an inspo off of my Pinterest board. So again, taking you back, I'm developing a dress for success range. It's businessy. Businessy to me is mainly like blazers and like super clean workwear, or at least that's where I'm starting from. So when I saw this picture, I was like, okay, it's fun, businessy. Obviously you'd put like some smart trousers on this outfit, or even some like good leggings, like work leggings, you know, I don't know. But as a jacket, not as a dress, as a jacket, I need to emphasize that this would be quite fun. So I tried to CAD this out, not for exactly what it is, but just as a starting point to develop my own designs. So starting with this one, like, what I understand this picture to be is like a jacket tucked in underneath some kind of overskirt. That's what I understand this outfit to be. It's two pieces. I'm trying to make just a jacket. So what I did is I just interpreted it into a jacket, and so I've just put a seam on that. This over panel, this panel here, let me click on it, is like one panel. Yeah, and it's just asymmetric to the other side. That's this bit, so it will just literally go over, but like it will be longer on one side. Then obviously you've got the offset pocket, and then I've just done that again but without some pleats in, you know, just to see like if it can just be straight and not too cinched. And then I've done another one, which is now you don't have the waist seam at all. It's just like a really, it's a cinched jacket, smooth on the front, just like, you know, yeah. And then I've done another one with the waist seam, but like I've done the eyelets. So this is after I had done that eyelet jacket that I showed earlier. And so I was flirting around with putting eyelets on. I don't know how businessy that would look, or how, you know, because the whole catch line here is feminine business attire. So I don't know, this seemed a bit extreme. I may just stick to the clean buttons. But you know, that's an idea of what I've done there. I've got something else that's fun from Pinterest. Your typical, very 80s shaped blazer, very extreme on the edges, like you know, those high shoulders, the boxy waist area. Yeah, I don't know, it screams 80s to me, but it's in, it's back, and I just thought of playing around with that shape and putting it into different fabrics. I also played around with the different sided fabric look, but again, this is just going on your party wear look. It's very flashy, very out there. May have to change, well, definitely will have to change fabrication for fitting the brief of like business attire. Here I have another sketch of mine. This was a sketch that was done for my last collection. It just never made it in. I ended up not sampling this. I came very close to sampling this in particular, but I just never picked it to go forward. So, you know, that's the fun of having lots of work done and building on your work and like being moldable and changeable with your work. Because now, you know, I have something to build upon rather than starting from scratch. So it's like, okay, now I'm doing business wear. This is quite fun as a shape. This could even be some kind of overcoat, you know? Like if it was, I'm imagining like a velvety and, you know, and your typical tuxedo collar just makes it scream like overcoat sort of thing. But you know, as a blazer, I caddied it up here and just I'm still thinking of what other fabrics could go. Oh, sorry, caddied it up here. That's this one. And then what I did when I caddied up the initial sketched one is I reworked the shape. So that's something that designers do a lot. You rework your shape. You go again, you go again, you go again, and you do it by just changing one feature. So it's like, okay, you make it a bit shorter, okay, like you cinch the waist in, or you bring the collar up, or you know, all kinds of things. This is, I would say, a development, like this one here, I would say is a development from this one. That's what I think this is from. This one a bit as well. But yeah, it's just all about playing. I'm really just like talking you through like where I'm starting from with this Dress for Success range and just the process and where it's gonna go, because really, really soon I'm gonna have samples done, like physical samples made and you know, all of that. And sometimes it's really easy to get like to run away on that part, but nobody ever sees the thinking process or the experimenting process or the ideas process. And I just really wanted to document this process, this part of it, because it's like the most important bit. So also I have this. Okay, let me try and get myself out of the way here. Oh, I don't know. I can't. I don't want to mess with that. Okay, I'll just move. Yeah, that will be fine. This is another sketch that was done for another collection. And again, I've put it into here. I've changed the fabrication to be smarter. So this is like pinstripe with black, you know, or just pinstripe on its own, or just black on its own. Then we have the black pinstripe. So yeah, all kinds of stuff going on there. This is kind of like an offset. So it's kind of got an offset slit there, but again, meant to be worn as a jacket, not a dress. So that's the fun part of this, you know, with the last range that I did, that was more on the evening wear side or like, you know, going out range. This is smart. This is like business attire. This is what you would wear in the day. So now I need to start thinking of outfit building, whereby what would I pair with this on the bottom, or you know, what goes with this. So that will come. But yeah, for now, we're just looking at the jackets. So here, I'll show you more sampling on the stand. So as I mentioned before, with this, I literally just put a men's, like it was some old charity shop men's jacket that I just cut away at and put a belt around, put some eyelet studs in, like studded it up and did something with it. And that became an actual shape of a design that I use. So I did the same with this cool jacket. This is a jacket that I bought, not too sure. But yeah, like it was originally, oh, I wish I had the original pictures. It was just literally your normal jacket. This is women's wear now. So it's nicer and it's cinched and it's like it fits better. But I cut it up. So I cut away here. I haven't committed to cutting this bit yet. I've just kind of tucked it in because I wasn't too sure whether I wanted to do that. But then on the side here, I'll move down a bit. I kind of tried to do like a double cut, so it's like cut twice. I don't know. I was just playing around with this. I just thought this could also be a cool shape. So I'll show you how I've caddied this up. Okay, for a start, we've got this, as I've shown you already. The belted jacket. I've done many, many colors of it. I'm just so excited for this one. I just feel like there's so much, you know, even like different color collars and things. Again, some swatches. These are the swatches that I mentioned earlier. I'm subscribed to all kinds of suppliers. Like I have a suppliers list as big as my arm that I have libraries of swatches that I can look at. And so I just put them into any design, any shape. It's almost like I've made it an equation. You know, you're looking at it as an equation. What is a design? A design is a garment. You just pick whether you want to do a top, trouser, jacket, whatever. Then what shape of that garment do you want it to be? You know, cut out, cinched, whatever the shape is. So when I say shape, I literally just mean like this. This right now is, I've got a shape here. Because we've not done the fabrication of it. And then the last bit of that equation is your fabrication. So that's where the swatches come in, or your color coding will come in. What is the fabrication of this? And then you've got design. So I played around with that even further. So I moved, what we would say is we would move this design along. So I came from moving this along from, you know, your belted studded blazer jacket, all of that, which is quite out there for what we're trying to do. We're trying to do feminine business attire. So I kind of tried to scale it down again, bring it back, and I was looking at kind of maybe this shape. So, you know, yeah, I was thinking about this, maybe without the belt, not too sure. Again, this is all work in progress. So I'll zoom out a bit just to see where I am. Yeah. So if we come down to here, this is that shape. This one is the shape that was on the stand, the one that I cut up. So it's a bit, I don't know, it looks a bit more oversized than the others. It's not as fitted looking, but ideally I would want the design to be fitted. So yeah, as a collection, I'm still yet to edit. So this is what you call an edit. You bring all of these ideas, you bring all of this work into a, bring all of this work into an edit. And that edit is what the collection will be, is what the range will be. So nice. Now that we are like up to speed with what exactly we're doing, what we're working from, I guess we can go ahead. So the first thing that I picked that I thought was quite ready to go was this. Your asymmetric blazer. I called it the asymmetric offset overlap blazer. I mean, it's not gonna be its like full name. But for cataloging for library, I just went with that. When you get your finals done, what you usually do is you give them a fun name. Like for example, the last range that I had, I end up naming them after flowers. So I had like the orchard dress or the violet, whatever, I don't know. So yeah, that's what they're that's what their like PR names would be. You'd get like a name to sell them as, but this name, as in like asymmetric offset overlap blazer, is just the name that we're cataloging it with. So I've got that here, and this is when we now begin tech packing, because as much as we've got this whole library of information here for everything, this is like the beginning of tech packing, but I feel like it's here where we're tech packing for that garment, if that makes sense. So, you know, I'm all about the process of learning. I'm all about people understanding how the design and development process goes in fashion, buying and merchandising. Because, again, as I always say, everybody deserves to have a chance to make it in that industry. I particularly had a very hard time trying to know what you need to do to get into that job or how you do something. So I'm all about the learning. Feel free to ask questions, feel free to contribute more, feel free to correct me on anything. But that's just basically the gist of what I'm trying to do. So now that we have our first pick, this is really exciting for me. I don't know, this is just like what I do all day long. But yeah, the first pick for Dress for Success is this. I'm quite happy with this, but also a bit nervous because it's a very, the shape is mad. The shape is quite mad. But yeah, it's okay. We can do this. So, the first thing we want to do when we're tech packing is we want to identify what the shape is and understand it. So there's no good sending something to a factory, to a manufacturer, and telling them like, yeah, like make this for me, but like you don't know how it's made up. And that's maybe one of the biggest problems people have trying to develop a range, who have never studied design, have never made anything themselves, because they don't understand the makeup of a garment. So what helps me a lot is the fact that I did do design. I have made garments, plenty of. I've done pattern cutting as well. Pattern cutting is like it's how you engineer a garment together. I don't know, the way I think of it is like you do the jigsaw puzzles of each piece of a garment on the paper, and then you sew that up until it makes the garment. And that really helps you understand what makes up a garment, because then when you're telling somebody like, make me a jacket, and then you've sketched something up, you're not sketching something that's impossible to technically impossible to put together. So if this doesn't make any sense, like, seriously, ask me any questions. But yeah, so I'll show you a brief, like, what's it called, a graded spec is where you now start to list all of the points that matter in the makeup of that garment. So I'll get this bit up. Right. Where am I? Yeah, so I started here, and I'll get a bit bigger. Try and get a bit bigger. Yeah. So these are your sample measurements, and like, when you give your manufacturer shape, because think about it, like, you've given them that drawing and you've told them to make it, but they need measurements, they need to know the scale of what you're trying to make. So these are the main points on a garment that matter. The rest they would use to make the pattern. So like, yeah, we're beginning here with the chest area, and then I'll flick back and forth to this. So right, we're starting with the chest. Yeah, I'll take you over to this. Not that. Right. So your chest area was point A, and that's here. And you literally need to put these on your tech pack. I'll explain why. So, whoops. Oh dear. Yeah, I'm just trying to go back to, yeah. So why this needs to be put on your, what's it called? On your tech pack, is because you're now pointing exactly where they're measuring it from. And you're saying it here. So chest, circumference, measure at underarm. These are all industry standards. Like, all of these terms that I've got here are your industry standards for how to measure, how to do a spec, how to measure for a tech pack, any measurement in industry at the chest for a garment that is a jacket or a top or anything, you will measure as circumference measure at the underarm. And that's like pulling the garment apart, lifting the sleeves up, and then like measuring those two points. And like, I've done that plenty of times in various retailers that I've worked for. When you're speccing, that's how they spec for real. So this is like industry standard. And then your sample size, it depends the type of retailer, because they would sample it according to their main demographic. So this is obviously for like maybe a younger brand, because they're sampling at a UK size 8 here. So if it was a older brand, like a brand where their demographic is for an older customer, they would use a sample size 12. Like that I know for sure. I've worked for many retailers that sample at size 12, because the UK average size for a woman is a size 12. From 35 upwards, it's like a size 14. So obviously it will just matter who your retailer is trying to connect with. Here we're looking at a younger brand, so it was sampling at size 8. And then when you decide what your measurement is, again, like, how do we decide what your measurement is? Okay, so I've done this based on those cutouts that I showed. So I'll just put those back up. So I've done this based on this jacket, like your actual physical jacket. And what I will say is, if you don't have, okay, so sometimes you're trying to make something that, like, you don't have, you, or that doesn't exist, and that's when a mannequin stand is very, very helpful, because you would measure the point on your mannequin and that will be the size that you use. Sometimes we call that modeling on the stand. I can do a video on that, where you would get what's it called, we call it modeling tape, to just like look at the points on that stand and to say, okay, I want the jacket to fit really snug on a size 8. So you'll just adjust your mannequin to a size 8. My mannequin is adjustable to whichever dress size you want, and then you would just like measure the point at the underarm, right? You would just measure it at the underarm. So going back to our tech pack, right? Right, I'm trying to find a... It wouldn't be 83. So these have been filled in from like my last garment, and I've just saved as. So this is obviously like... actually... 83. This might actually be right, but I'm going to keep these in because this is just exemplary for now. But yes, so chest 83 circumference at underarm for your size 8. What I love about having a pre-populated or pre, that's not the right word, a formulated graded spec is it's got the formulas in. So now this is already like, it already knows to calculate it down. And if I was to change this to like, oh no, it's really like 80, or let's say it was really 90, everything else here would change up or down depending on the size that you want. Because in grading, certain points go up and down dependent on the point that they're at. I know this is getting very technical, but I guess that's why we're here, right? We're here to get technical. So basically, a chest on a size 8 is going to be 4 centimeters bigger than a size 6, and then a size 6 is going to be 4 centimeters bigger than a size 4. Chest goes up and down by 4 centimeters on any garment. So that's all pre-populated there. All of these change according to what you put in your sample size, right? And what I will do is I will make a free template of a graded spec, so it will be very easy for anybody wanting to do a tech pack to a factory, where you would just literally populate there and say, oh, okay, no, I want a really loose one, I want it 100 centimeters, and then it will be graded for you along whichever size you wanted. I will also fill in recommended measurements per fit and stuff, because, you know, this is information I've collated from years in the industry and just knowing how a graded spec goes, how to put a tech pack together. But this is all really handy. So I'm just going to put that back to 83. And then when we look at waist is the circumference measure at 18 centimeters under on your underarm. And this is very, very technical, but it's precise regardless of what garment you're making, because on your body, your waist is going to be 18 centimeters underneath your underarm. So, and this is women's wear, by the way, I'm specifically in women's wear. So, I will go back to the tech pack drawing where we have here, point B is drawn down here. And yeah, it's 18 centimeters under. So what we do when we're measuring, we literally just get a tape measure and we like measure all of these points and make sure we go down 18 centimeters, and we measure across from there. And whatever the circumference is on the waist, that's what you want your measurement to be. So I'll go back to here. Your hip is 36 centimeters from underarm. Whoops, that's not spelled correctly. Right, so your waist is even lower. It's another 18 centimeters down, but it's 36 all the way from the underarm. So all of these are graded by 4 centimeters. Yeah? Same for bottom. Bottom is 4. So this is the absolute edge of your garment. So when we're looking at a garment, basically it goes bigger in increments of 4 centimeters, because all of these measurements are measured across that way. So if you're going a size bigger, it goes 4 centimeters bigger. If you're going another size bigger, it's another 4 centimeters bigger. Yeah, for chest, waist, and hip. If we're going to now measure the front length. The front length, I'll show you which point that is. It is 5E. So it's from your highest shoulder point all the way down to the edge of the garment. That's what a front length is. Because this is asymmetric, I've done front length right and front length left. Usually you just do front length on one side, but here we are. So just trying to get the other one back up. So these increments go up differently. They go up by 0.5, right? So now we can see how a garment grades. A garment grades by 4 centimeters in width, but then it grades by 0.5 that way, because obviously it's just common sense, like somebody's only bigger like in that way. And then it gets longer, yes, as well, because you need more fabric for negotiating, but not as much. So it's only 0.5 when we're looking at front length. Sleeve length is also the same. Sleeve length goes up and down in increments of 0.5. So we can really see how this chart is really helpful. And it's really, sometimes I feel sorry for people who are trying to do a tech pack when they don't understand these things, because you're just going to be at the mercy of the factory that you've sent your drawing to. without giving somebody these detailed pieces of information, your fit is only going to be so good. That's why I'm very passionate about like well-constructed garments. I know the work that goes into it, and also the technical understanding that goes into making something come up fitted nicely is, in all honesty, very lacking these days. A lot of garments are just, you know, not hugging your body as you'd want. And when we're looking at making something like business attire, I'm really, really trying to get this like right. I'm really doing the nitty gritty measurements and all of that. I've been on the stand. I will record a lot more work from on the stand to be able to capture these measurements to put on this chart that you then use to grade, because that is also very important. But yeah, I'm just trying to, like, you know, hopefully Skillshare here, because this is what's needed for a garment to fit correctly. And I know it may feel like it's not common sense, but it is. So as we go further down, you have a shoulder point. Your shoulder points, sorry, I've skipped a few, which is your bicep and your cuff measure. I'll do these first before I go on to shoulder point. Your bicep goes up and down by 1 centimeter because that's on your arm, and so it won't scale as much as the body. So the body goes up and down in increments of 4 centimeters. The bicep is going up and down in increments of 1. So I'll show you the point at which you measure the size that you want your bicep to be on your garment, and that will be here. Here, point H. And point H, is exactly on your underarm. So when you lift the sleeve up, that seam part, you want to do it 90 degrees. And all the instructions are put here on the tech pack, where it says literally bicep, full circumference across sleeve at 90 degrees from underarm. And this is industry standard as well. Like, it sounds so random, but this is how every single garment is measured in the industry. Like, it's all done in a certain way where you lift the sleeve, underarm seam, and then you do it 90 degrees because that's going to give you the full bicep measurement, and it's done as a circumference. It's only ever done as a flat if it's knitwear, that I know for sure, or jersey as well. Jersey is classified as a knit because it's not woven, it's like literally knit. But anyway, not to put too much information out there and confusion, that's how you would measure that. Cuff measure is less. So your cuff, again, would only go up and down in increments a lot less than your bicep or your body, because it's a different part of the body. And so if you think about these things, they all just make sense. So this one only goes up in increments of 0.5. And the cuff measure is right at the edge of a garment. So for this garment, it's just right on your edge. I'll show you. It's down here, right on the edge. If it was a button shirt that had proper cuff, then it would be the bit before you go to the edge. But here we don't really have like your traditional cuff. The cuff on this garment is pretty much the edge. That's what we're saying the cuff is. So I'll go back to our tech pack, and then now we have the shoulder. Whoops. The shoulder is even less, guys. So the shoulder goes up and down in increments of 0.25, right? Because the shoulder is literally like this bit. And when people are bigger in size, it doesn't mean they've now grown more bone on their shoulder. It's just the sizing is like more to do with weight, I think. So what, like if you think about it, if you put on weight, you're not going to like grow an extra shoulder. So it's only like really minimal. It's only for seam allowance. And so it's 0.25 in increments. And I'll show you the shoulder point on your Techpack. The measuring point for the manufacturer to note is here, J. Up here, and that's your shoulder point. So, I'll try and get through the last bits. We have the back. The back goes up and down in increments of one. This is done as a flat, not as a circumference, because we measured this point on yoke or 10 centimeters down from the neck point. And that is a very specific point to measure the size of your back, but every garment will be measured this way. And so again, that's why I feel like it will be really useful to make a standardized template of what a graded spec measurements is, should be. I'll make an industry standard one, and I'll make that really accessible for anybody who wants to get their hands on that, anybody who wants to use it. Because these things are all done the same in every single retailer. It's so funny, but that's how it's done. Because when you're in pattern making, a pattern is only drawn in a particular way, and they use these points to kind of like draw out the shape of your pattern, your garment. So the back is here, K. That's about 10 centimeters down from your neck point and on the yoke. So this garment doesn't have a yoke, but a yoke is always done 10 centimeters down. Like, yeah, that's just how it is. If it's a shirt, it's done like a bit higher, but not too far off from this point, because a yoke is meant to be for the back. So yeah, there you go. The last bit we have is, well, I say last bit, there's still quite a bit to go, but things like front neck drop, which is measured from your highest shoulder point, which is like all the way up here, down to the base of the V. So you would measure it like that and then like that. That bit on here I'm just struggling with all of these. Yeah, so that would be this point here. Your base of your V is here. So you'd measure it like that way. Right, so collar always remains the same. It's just the same on every size. And then your center back length goes up and down in increments of one. That's just the point from the back of your neck all the way to the end of the garment. And then your front opening is measured at 18 centimeters neck drop. So that's this point here. And then we have your bottom. Because it's asymmetric, again, I have a bottom for right and for left. And so that looks like this. Yeah, so I would have this and this. I need to know these measurements on each side to be able to give the factory, you know, some good information. So I think that's just a little bit about what I I'm up to, what I'm working on. I thought it would just be helpful to talk through and message with any questions, with any information you want to see. Yeah, like this is it. This is in progress, and I'm just really excited to hopefully get there and to have some decent samples done soon. Thanks so much, guys. I am going to sign off now, and I'll be uploading this way now. It's just so much better. Let me know if that works or doesn't work or anything in between. But this way, I'll actually get some content out and hopefully give some useful information. Until next time, guys. Bye. Bye. See ya.